The hardest question my friends ask me is, when's my birthday? I don't like to think about my birthday, because it's not important to me. I don't celebrate like my friends celebrate their birthdays. My friends always apologise for missing it, and they say they forgot the date. I won't forget the date though, because it's the same day as my mum's birthday.
Happy birthday to you!
Happy birthday, Sarah.
Don't forget to make a wish.
I can't wait to give him my present.
Yeah, it's been a great party.
Thanks so much, guys. I don't know what to do first. Have cake, open presents, or both?
Hey, come on, you guys. No need to rush. I'll cut the cake for you and you can open your presents.
I sometimes get jealous when it's my friends' birthdays. All the presents, balloons, and cake. I never show it, though. This is the part I hate the most. Everyone has great gifts, but I can't afford nice presents and I sometimes get embarrassed. If only my friends could understand that I...
Come on, Ellen, come join us.
Sarah's opened everything.
Yeah, it's been so much fun. My gift was by far the best.
No, it wasn't. Mine was actually...
Hey, Ellen hasn't opened her present yet. Could be the best one by far.
Sarah is the person who understands me the most. I want to tell her. I should tell her. But I can't. I'm not ready to talk about it yet.
The care for my daughter was quite a lot of issues. Sarah has been had health issues since she was a little girl. She's getting older now, and it's getting more and more difficult. You always try to be protective towards them. And yet, they don't feel they want it because they feel closed in, hemmed in. They want a life of their own. Yeah. What do you know? You're past it. How do you know what's going to happen? If that makes sense. If you're talking of an adult which has had disabilities throughout the lifetime, then they still have those childlike tendencies. Yeah. But at the same time, they're frustrated and they... I'm growing up, I don't need you. Yeah. And yet, they still need that input.
Come on, Sarah, time to get up. Come on, Sarah.
Oh, I can do it myself.
Go on then, hurry up.
When she was younger, we had a lot of help from the social services. But now, it's as if she's gone off the radar and nobody seems to want to help.
This beach is my favourite place to be. It's so peaceful and quiet. It gives me some time to myself and to clear my thoughts. This time is my time. This feeling changes when I get home. I'm not saying that I don't look forward to going home. It's just that it's nice sometimes being alone.
Hello.
Hiya, lovely.
I see you here every day. I've just come back from a party. I have some cake. I probably shouldn't have it though. Would you like some?
Oh, thank you. That's really thoughtful of you. Isn't that nice, David?
Hello, would you like some cake?
He won't speak to you today, lovely. He's having one of his quiet days. But tell you what, give me the cake and I'll give it to him later. He loves his cake.
I best be off now. My mum will be waiting for me.
All right then, thanks, lovely.
Bye.
Ta-da.
She has to go to appointments, to see the doctor, the hospital. And it's such a trauma to get her there. I got no car, I got no transport. Hospitals are always miles away. It would be nice if we had a bit of me time.
No, I don't want to
come in.
Come on,
sweetheart.
No, I want to go home.
We're just going to see the good nice doctor. He'll make this better for you.
No, I want to go home now. I don't like it. I want to go home.
Oh, come on. We've come a long way for you.
No, it's time to go home now. No, I want to go home.
Even though she says she can cope, I don't think she can. I took her to see the doctor the other day. And although I know there's so many issues that she needs to tell him, she goes in and she tells him she's all right. And I just feel as though I have no voice. Sarah's now reaching the point where she feels she's independent, but I can't leave her. What am I to do? They don't sit with her. They only see her when they're talking to her for 10, 15 minutes. But at home, it's a different situation. There are times where I've just gone out of frustration, because if I didn't, I'd go screaming mad. Yeah, it's good catching up with you. Oh, Megan, I'd love to, but I've got Sarah to look after. I can't leave her on her own, and I feel so lonely. I got no one to turn to. Maybe we can catch up again. And maybe if you give me a ring next week, I might be able to do something. Yeah, Megan, I'll see you. Bye.
I get up at 6 a.m. I'm the first one up. After I get ready, I get my younger brother ready for school. He has a lot of energy in the mornings. I make him breakfast, and then it's time to leave. I drop him off to school. I like it when he's happy. I want him to be happy and have no worries. I then walk home, but stop at the shops on the way. When I get home, it's time to get Mum out of bed. I then have to wash her in the shower because she finds it difficult. I make her breakfast and we sit and watch the telly. We sometimes play board games. I often think about what my friends are doing. They're going to uni, getting jobs, going out to nightclubs, house parties, and going to gigs. But I can't do that because I have to look after my family. I do have hobbies though, playing guitar, video games, reading, and listening to music.
So, how's everything going at home?
Once a week, I go to a carers group where I meet with other carers.
I care for my parents, and it's all working out well.
It's a place to make new friends and get advice, and it's been so helpful. It's made my family's life easier. We get to go on trips. I like going to places like this because I missed out on opportunities because I had to care for my mum when I was growing up.
Parents are feeling a bit better now because we've been feeling very ill lately and everything's getting better.
We have new carers joining every week. Ellen started last week and it's changed her life. It has made life easier and it's helped me become a better carer. Oh, time to pick my brother up from school. It can be hard, but I love my family, and I do enjoy caring for them. I couldn't do it without the help I'm given. Anyway, time for bed. Same thing again tomorrow.
Because I do so much, I'm always tired, and I don't sleep well because I have all these thoughts in my head. So many things I have to remember. So many tasks and duties. I get so stressed out sometimes.
You never come out anymore.
Yeah, you've changed.
You're missing out on all the fun.
You've become so boring.
What should I do? I feel like I'm the only other person in the world that's going through this. And just like that, it's 6 a.m. I'm so tired. I just want to go back to bed. but I have to do the shopping and make breakfast before school.
Hello, lovely. God, you're up early.
Yeah, I'm just going to the shops. Are you okay?
Yeah. It's just my son.
What's happened? Is he okay?
Yeah, he's fine. He's down there. But it's different every day. We have good days, we have bad days. Yeah, mostly good days. Is there someone you're looking after?
My mum.
Well, firstly, it's amazing what you're doing. I bet your friends haven't got a clue how hard it is for you at home.
No, my friends don't. No one does.
You're not alone, you know.
Really?
Yeah, there's hundreds, maybe thousands of other people like us out there. People who look after someone in their family.
I had no idea.
Yeah. And there's places you can go where you can meet other carers. You can meet other young people your age who help to care and have somebody to talk to.
Really?
Since coming to the carers, I've been able to share my burden with other people. I know that I'm not on my own. And that is give me thought for how I can deal with different situations. It's getting better. Because I've been able to talk to people and use some of the things that I've learned or picked up from the carers group, I've been able to use it and approach Sarah in a different manner, and it's worked. And it's also important that sort of message is put out to the public. The RCT carers group is there to support anyone who is caring and has the responsibility for whether it's a child or an adult or an older person, because as a group, you learn to share information, share burdens, and then go home and look at things from a different perspective. And sometimes that little discussion will help and improve you as a person who's caring.
Now when my friends ask me when my birthday is, I'm happy to tell them.